Hello everyone, in this video we have one square and one side of the square is given 4 units. These two parts are given as equal and these two angles is also given equal. And then the question is, what is the area of the yellow shaded triangle? Okay, first of all, we know that this side is 4 units. Therefore, these two parts must be equal to units, right? Okay. Corners of the square are 90 degrees, so these are must be equal 90 degrees. After that, if we draw a perpendicular from the point E onto the line AF, like this, and let's call here alpha, here is also alpha, and here, let's call theta. Notice that alpha plus theta equal 90 degrees, right? So here must be equal theta. Okay. Let's call here point K. If you notice that this triangle and this triangle have same angles, and these two triangles have same hypotenuse, right? That means these two triangles are congruent. So triangle ADE and triangle AKE are congruent. Therefore, if there's a 4 units opposite of the theta, for this triangle, opposite of the theta must be equal 4 units. Likewise, if there's a 2 units opposite of the alpha, for this triangle, opposite of the alpha must be equal 2 units. Next step, let's call here y. So 4 minus y left here. And then this part, let's call here x. If we connect point E and point F like this, x and y must be equal, right? Why? Because if you focus on this triangle, 2 squared plus x squared must be equal 2 squared plus y squared. So that means x must be equal y. As a result, triangle FKE and triangle FCE are congruent. Right? So, if you focus on this triangle, we can apply Pythagorean theorem. Therefore, 4 squared plus 4 minus y whole squared equal 4 plus x whole squared. You know that x equal y. So, if you substitute x instead of the y, we get 16 plus 16 minus 8x plus x squared equal 16 plus 8x plus x squared. These are again, so these are also again. That means 16 equal 16x, so x is equal to y and y is equal to 1. That's right here. Here is 1 and here is 3. So now we can calculate the area of the triangle easily, right? So yellow shaded area equal 4 times 3 over 2. That means the area equal 6 unit square. Okay, this was the first method. Now we will calculate the area of the triangle using second method. First of all, let's call these two angles alpha. And if we extend corner C and corner E like this, let's call here point K. We know that these two sides are parallel, right, because of square. So if it is alpha, that means here must be equal alpha. If you focus on triangle AFK, notice that this triangle have same base angles, right? That means this triangle is an isosceles triangle. So triangle KFA is an isosceles triangle. Therefore, the length of the AF must be equal to the length of the FK. Next step, we know that here is 4 units. If you notice that, there is a butterfly here, right? So, if here is 4 units, that means the side length must be equal 4 units. Or you can think like this, this triangle and this triangle are congruent. Okay, this length I want to represent with x, so 4 minus x left here. After that, if it is x plus 4, that means this side length must be equal x plus 4. Therefore, if we apply Pythagorean theorem for this triangle, 4 minus x squared plus 4 squared equal x plus 4 whole squared. If you notice that, this equation is the 3, 4, 5 spatial triangle equation, right? So 4 minus x must be equal 3. Therefore, x is going to be 1 unit. So let's write here 1. That means here must be equal 3. So yellow shaded area is going to be 6 units square. Now also, let's calculate the area of the yellow shaded triangle using third methods. Let's call these angles alpha. So we know that these two sides are parallel. That means here must be equal to alpha. Here is 4, here is 2, and let's call here x. If we calculate tangent to alpha, tangent to alpha equal 4 over x. So we know that the expansion of tangent to alpha equal 2 times tangent alpha over 1 minus tangent squared alpha equal 4 over x. So let's calculate tangent alpha. Tangent alpha equal 2 over 4. So 1 half. Let's plug in this value to the equation. 2 times 1 half over 1 minus 1 half whole squared equal 4 over x. These are again. So x equal 4 minus 1, that means x equal 3 units. Let's write here x equal 3. That means the area of the yellow shaded triangle equal 6 unit square. Thanks for watching. If you want more videos like this, please don't forget like and subscribe my channel. Take care and bye bye.